to defeat the system of white supremacy. There's just no way around it. That should be what we think about when we get up in the morning and go to bed at night. Every person of color on the planet should have that as a priority. And not just defeat the system of racism, but replace it with what it should have been in the first place. And what would that be? The system of justice, in capital letters. And what is justice? Guaranteeing that no person is mistreated. And guaranteeing that the person that needs help the most gets the most constructive help in every area of activity. 24/7. Economics, education, entertainment, labor, law, politics, religion, sex, and war. Nobody in any of those areas of activity is supposed to be mistreated at any time, under any circumstance. And everybody, at all times, is supposed to be given the most constructive, underlying constructive, help in all of those areas of activity, 24/7, on the planet. That's what we should have the ambition of replacing the system of white supremacy with. Because the system of white supremacy is designed just to do what? To support what? Injustice. Imbalance between people. It's totally against justice. It's totally against anybody getting of color, getting constructive help. Now, they'll give you all the non-constructive help that you want. Anything stupid that black people are going to do, and you don't have to take my word for it, just look at, just do, start doing something that doesn't matter too much. Something that's non-constructive. Something spreading drugs among black people. The white supremacists will help you do that. That's why that's part of the black economy. Drugs. Before then, in the Northwestern Hemisphere, underground, you might say, it was whiskey, bootleg whiskey, and numbers. They'd let you do some of that, all right, without too much punishment. They'd put a little bit of hurting on you to let you know that it was illegal. But for years, in a lot of small towns, and I was in one, everybody looked up to whom? The bootlegger.
Mm.
Back in the old days, back in the 30s and 40s, I had, quote-unquote, care people, family members, quote-unquote, I mean, who were into bootlegging. Why? Because that's where the money was. Now it's black people slaughtering each other about drugs, non-white people, Mexican gangs slaughtering each other, drugs. You know, and the white supremacists will deal in it when it's profitable to them. But just like in Godfather 1, what did they say? It'll affect mostly the dark people, the colors. Let them lose their souls. They're nothing but animals anyway. All right? But now the white supremacists, like the law of compensation, which is in the title of my book, what you put out, you just might get some of it back on you.
Yeah.
You put out poison, you might get some of that poison on you.
Mm.
Now, you have what? In some sectors, not in all, but in some sectors among white people, you have what? You have something called opium or opioids or what you call prescription drug that is affecting white people themselves.
Mm-hmm.
See, so I'm saying this to white people who believe in white supremacy. Be careful what you put out on black people, because some of it may come back to haunt you.
Okay, gotta leave.
However, the white supremacists now are very shrewd. They know this.
Okay.
They don't mind having what you call white sacrifices.
All right.
I talk about that in the text.